Hi, and welcome back to another episode of Leaving the Farm right here at TammyPepperman.org and also at Revolution Radio at freedomslips.com. We are entirely listener, watcher, and reader supported. You can donate to Freedom Slips by going to www.freedomslips.com. And clicking on our support pages every little bit helps. And of course, I have a request through TammyPepperman.org. We are entirely supported by you. If you like what you're seeing, if you like what you're hearing, please donate to our web hosting, who has donated their time and effort and energy and out of pocket everything to keep us not only on the web but also on the air at No Borders Radio. And to do that, please visit PayPal, and you can donate to Ben, our web hosting service, by going at ben@tpuc.org. And you can also find this at TammyPepperman.org, or go to the web development itself, Tamworth Web Development .co.uk. This has been overwhelming, to say the least. Today in Illinois, it was crazy to see yet again more clear and present danger doctrine put out by these attorneys that are cashing in on everybody. From the MarketWatch.com, BlogsMarketWatch.com, Illinois ruling could derail pension reform. The Illinois Supreme Court ruled on Thursday that the state's constitutions forbids cuts to the health care benefits of retired state employees. Yada, yada. Okay, this is all clear and present danger doctrine. Senate, House of Representatives, they're offering you the fear that your benefits are going to be taken away in order to get you to buy those benefits. However, pensions themselves are biohazardous. They're hazardous to your health. And the reason for that is that pension schematics themselves are not only someone betting for your productive value, these are what funds are. But someone is betting against it, which is what a hedge is. They're hedging a bet. What happens after that is determinant only on the players playing. Who's playing? Who's hedging? Who's funding? Who's doing these things upon you? Those are the directors, the banks. Not what you think of as banks. Attorneys are bankers. The representation you see every day, U.S. Bank, Wells Fargo, these are only representations of the court, the legal system itself. The court is central to any capitalist market. It is attorneys who are tricking out humanity on a global scale. And we would love to address now the those on corporate employee, state employee, federal employee, because you are being targeted at a very, very, very fast pace. This is also relative to Nazi Germany, exactly identical to what the Bear Corporation did at that time, 1927. Bear Corporation came into the world courts as the Republic of Germany and said, look, I've got a whole bunch of overhead. I've got a whole bunch of overhead, and I'm just hemorrhaging all these funds. And the Bear Corporation, of course, asked Congress to indemnify Poland. And at that point, all of the Polish state employee and federal employee were cold. That's what everyone saw as Nazi Germany, what sparked what appeared to be that grand grand presentation. It was actually calling the overhead, and it wasn't the citizen. The citizen always turns back into a refugee during these banker wars. That's also the action of fornicating. It's prostitution when you are taking a benefit while screaming for your rights, telling them you want these pension funds, you want to hedge everything, you want to be secure. You're already secure before the attorney came in and started terrorizing you through fourth generation warfare. You were already secure before the attorney came in to put his hand in there, her hand in there, to raise your estate. You were already secure before the attorney came after you with charges. You were already secure before the attorney came after you with the IRS. You were already secure before. And the predator on the other end never changes. It's always been the attorney. All the way back to Matthew 27. Barabbas. The murderer. Barabbas. The etymology on that name means son of the master. It's not patronizing you. It's not patronizing the word of God. The attorney is worshipping a demigod called Marduk, or the god of Baal, Baalism, Baal. Now what the attorney does is it comes in and it takes something of yours that you already own and holds it hostage in exchange for ransom. That's also known as the action of piracy. So say you have a retirement that the attorney is threatening. He's holding that ransom until you go through legal process and pay the ransom to buy it back from the same attorney that's telling you it's defending it. Say you have a child and you're going through a divorce. The attorney's going to come in and it's going to grab that child and hold it hostage until you pay the legal fees to buy it back out of the system. Say the attorney wants to take the child off of you because you're not going through a divorce and there's no other way for it to pit you against each other. It'll bring in CPS. It'll do the same thing to your parents and grandparents through adult protection. If it can't turn you against each other, it'll figure out a way to take your money off of you, take your houses, take yourselves, take each other, take your kids, your grandparents, uncles, aunts. It'll figure it out. What it does is that. It doesn't do anything else. Its function is as your adversary. The etymology on Satan is your adversary. I was very concerned when I saw this story come out today because it prompts people into fear. Fear of losing their pensions. Fear of losing their retirements. When somebody's betting on your production and then they're betting on the other end, your death, this is risk. That's how the game works. To create that risk, they have to attack you in some manner. Sociologists study humanity, of course. And when you go into the study of sociology and economics at the same time, rather than compartmentalizing, you realize that this is social engineering, yada yada. Civil engineering is really good business for the attorneys. Now, my concern over you screaming for your pensions is a little thing known as death derivatives. Because as you age, after the age of 50, you are determined that your production lags. They have to make you produce in a different way. If your hands aren't working, your legs aren't working, your arms aren't working, your back's not working, and you're not as efficient as you once were, the attorney's going to come in and throw some money in the pot and bet on your death. Because it's a risk against your pension. They don't want you to claim disability. They don't want you to retire. You're not going to live that long. according to the attorneys. Please don't fight for your pensions. This is begging them to kill you. You can go to, I think it was on BBC. Let me go there real quick and get that story up for you. It was on Bloomberg, actually, a few years ago, 2011. Death derivatives emerge from pension risks of living too long. Goldman Sachs, which is a court, its attorneys. Deutsche Bank, which is a court, it is attorneys. And JP Morgan Chase & Company, which is a court, they are attorneys, which bundled and sold billions of dollars of mortgage loans, now want to help investors bet on people's debts. Right there, they're blaming the investors. Did you know that you're human trafficking? Do you have an oath under the Banking Act, under 12 U.S.C. subsection 73 that says, I'm not hypothecated, but my client is? 12 U.S.C., of course, is the banking. These attorneys are absolutely detrimental to human life. From Black's Law Dictionary, first edition, bank. A bench or seat. The bench or tribunal occupied by the judges. The seat of judgment, a court. The full bench or full court, the assembly of all the judges of a court. A sitting in bank is a meeting of all the judges of a court, usually for the purpose of hearing arguments on demurrers, points reserved, motions for new trials, etc., as distinguished from the sitting of a single judge at the assizes or nisi prius, and from trials at bar. But in this sense, bane is a more usual form of the word. Of course, we don't talk a lot about the assizes. The assizes are sessions of seizure or court. And of course, the representation of the one that seizes is called seizure. You have been worshipping the attorney and asking it to represent you. You've been worshipping the attorney in the black robe. 1 Corinthians 6 really frowns on that. So fornicating. You are fornicating at that time. That is prostitution if you're renting your body to it. That's prostitution. If it taxes you 38% tax on your productive value, that's prostitution. It's promoting prostitution. From etymonline.com, the etymology on the word of turn, quote, to turn over to another, to turn to, assign, banking assignment, attribute, dispose. From a, meaning to, turner, to turn. In feudal law, quote, to transfer homage or allegiance to another lord. What about bank fees in a fiefdom? Why is a court sitting in every community tricking you out, renting you to each other? Why are these attorneys allowed to exist for so long without stopping them? These things are just, it's profoundly amazing that it could be so ingrained and integrated and yet so smooth in its ability to be a plague upon mankind. It's an absolute plague. This is foul. The attorneys everywhere in every corner. Recently reported Lindsay Lohan has sued over grand theft auto character that according to her, is, quote, awful and apparently mimics her so much that she's claiming they use her as the example for such. Of course, it's an interesting concept. She watched a movie about a psychopath and said, that's me, you're talking about me. She said, you're known for your works and actions. You're not known by what you say, you're known by what you do. And it reminded me of a story a few years ago. This poor guy, Mark Byron, he had posted on his Facebook page, quote, if you are an evil, vindictive woman who wants to ruin your husband's life and take your son's father away from him completely, all you need to do is say that you're scared of your husband or domestic partner, end quote. Although Mark Byron never used a name and only described an evil, vindictive woman who wants to ruin your husband's life and take your son's father away from him completely, Elizabeth Byron learned of the post, took this up as her title, and asked a judge to protect her, the psychopath in reference, evidencing that indeed she had done these things upon another human being. Satan, of course, being what it is in the black robe, ordered Mark to apologize for offending her ego or spend some time in jail rather than holding Elizabeth accountable for falsely accusing Mark Byron and ruining not only his life, but that also of the children. These things have to stop. Why would you pay homage and patronize a thing that has allowed this to occur? And he was penalized. She's the one that took up the title of psychopath. And these attorneys in black dresses are putting children with those things. They don't like children. They don't like men or women or anybody except for themselves. They love those titles. They love that ego, which is what she was defending. And what the attorney in a black dress said was injured or brought into law. She's absolutely the whore of Babel, buying what he's selling. And here this judge and this psychopath work together, promoting peaceful relationships. They were in agreement, weren't they? They were in a pact together. And they had conspired against not only Mark Byron, but the children involved. They conspired against children. And this is only one example. This is every day you find this in family and probate court across the globe because of the political tool of feminism that allows her to be so lawless. She's absolutely unbound. Without the truth, there is nothing. And yet her army will protect her in the court of Assisi as she worships that thing and it pets her and strokes her ego. And that's exactly what happened. I mean, she's not off the hook. The court is hooking her out as much as it is the father. It was interesting to have a conversation commentary-wise on the AV Club post via Discus today because of the mindset. You know, so I read this story on Lindsay Lohan, and my comment was, amazing how little girls think that the mirror is lying if a movie is made of a psychopathic creature and a psychopath answers this call. Is that not a psychopath? So Odd Duck comes on and it says, little boys think that too. Everyone does, really. No, I said, if the shoe fits, surely you do not speak on behalf of everyone, as I evidently do not act in such manner, do you? And Odd Duck came back and said, I don't know you, but if your point was that some people see themselves differently than who they really are, I believe that's a pretty universal human experience. I said, no. I've never watched or observed or witnessed any behavior and taken it up as mine if it was not mine, looking in the mirror. When that is not universal, it would be subjective. If you feel you're a psychopath and this offends you, you would react and defend that title as Loan has done in this example. And I exemplified in an article I had written years ago about the female psychopath. The most profound thing happened after that. I wrote and described the female psychopath. And so on my blog, so these female psychopaths would come along and say, why do you hate me? Why do you hate all females? I'm like, I just described you and you took that as your title. You said, I don't like you. Well, that I don't like female psychopaths. Of course I don't like female psychopaths. But I definitely don't hate anybody else that that doesn't apply to. It only applies to the one who's titled that belongs to. If you're acting as a psychopath and you see your description when I write about you, well, if it walks like a duck and quacks like a duck, it's a duck. It's not a horse or anything. You know, and then I was reminded of Matthew 7, of course. Matthew 7:15, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. You shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good fruit tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. And of course, that's like the most, my favorite, of course, as I only adhere to the truth, you're known by your works and actions. It's the physics of a thing. Don't tell me that you're a victim while you're, you know, sticking a knife in my back or whatever else you're going to be doing with your time other than doing what you say you are doing. And that's something that will always mark everybody. Everyone will be marked according to their works. And it's so sad because the majority don't even realize what they're doing. You know, you just keep on going headlong the same path you're on, and that path is just driving you into a very, very sad place. Very sad place. You want to buy the stairway to heaven. You want to buy your rights. You want to buy your benefits. You want to buy all of these things. And when you're purchasing from that tree of knowledge, it's killing you. There's no other way that you will end up. That is what is occurring. There's no other result to the path that you're on. There's only one way, and that is according to the truth. You cannot escape reality. It doesn't matter who you are. If you're, you know, the richest attorney or the most lowly of whatever, you can use all the pretty words you want to. You can dress it up in all sorts of color and ideology. Doesn't change the physics. It'll never change the absolute, which is always the truth. That is the foundation of everything. You can't tell a tree that it's going to be a dog today, or a blade of grass that it is water. It's not going to change and alter its being to fit your perception, which is what this society has been running on for so long. These words and ideologies, these psychological aspects, giving you a different picture, a different view in the mind, created by concepts. It's just when that all goes away, you still have the physics of a thing. That doesn't alter or change. It's still the absolute. It doesn't matter. You know, you can break it up into as many parts as you want to under the doctrine of Thomas. It's still going to have the absolute in its origin or core. And so many now are whining and crying about these things, and it's so sad because, okay, what do you want me to do? They were your works. I didn't pick up your hand and do these things. You did. I didn't make the same choices you did. I chose a very, very opposite path. If you are one of the ones whining at this time, because it's just like, that has been the greatest irritant. I don't have any sympathy whatsoever for you. I'm not indoctrinated with the doctrine of chivalry. I have absolutely no chivalry for you. I'm not here to protect your ego. I'm not here to jump through any hoops for you and make sure that, you know, your ego is nice and placated. And I'm never going to give you a pacifier to suck on and make you feel better for what you've done. Ever. But that is completely and backwards to anything that I'm about. From the Guardian today, baby boomers were soft than those starting work in the 1990s. Sad. Sad. They treat everybody so horrifyingly wrong, and you're still patronizing it and asking it for benefits, and it's not good for you to do that. It's detrimental for your health. It was neat to see on the BBC News that more attorneys and such have been, you know, they're rolling on them in this GSK case at GlaxoSmithKline. China, systematic bribery at GSK, China credible, says investigator. It's been interesting. Allegations that pharmaceutical giant GSK systematically bribed doctors in China are credible, says an investigator hired by the firm. Of course, this is on the BBC.com. I think their original source was The Guardian. But after he finished his report, he learned the details of further allegations against the firm and told colleagues he believed they were true. GSK told the BBC it did not tolerate corruption in its business. Well, it is corrupt. It's a death machine. It's actually more equivalent to Auschwitz than the majority of all of their other tactics, because it's soft sell and it's very quiet in its relationship to how it causes human demise. And these side effects of medications, I don't know how you're accepting that in your mind as anything that started out as any good ideology or good idea. Side effect simply means that. It's another sideways effect. And there's an attorney cashing in because it's betting on your productive value. So if you get sick because you have taken a prescription medication, that's more money in the attorney pocket. It doesn't increase the liability on that corporation or GSK. It doesn't lose anything when one of you dies. It gains all of that profit that it earned while you were producing in the medical, psychological, or criminal industry. The criminal aspect, of course, is when they get you hooked on these drugs. And then you have also a side effect of criminality when you have to maintain that usage. And of course, you've got the attorney back behind you in the corporation that was your former employee when it laid you off accidentally. And then you fell on more hard times and the IRS started attacking you, which is the same attorney. And all of these things started happening and you went for the drugs. You gotta have them. You're dealing with addiction and it's a cyclical pattern with the attorney at the center of everything. Now, we've seen a lot of doctors with their hands in the pot. But it is not as many as there are practicing medicine. I don't believe at this time, as far as that goes. I personally spoke to the doctor that was dosing Joseph Reynolds with Ativan and Haldol at the same time as he was being given salt water to kill him. And this was in November, December. And the minute I told him that I was witness to evidence of genocide, of course, he got off the phone with me in a hurry. And then, of course, you follow through with that and you, excuse me. Mm-hmm. You go to the conversation I had with the conservator from McHenry County, Illinois, an attorney. And I was told by him that he has to diagnose somebody before he can maintain as a conservator. The trustee thing over the bankrupt state. So of course with Joseph Reynolds we go back to death derivatives. The risk he was creating by living longer than 89, 90. And the risk he was creating to the supplement of hedge fund management. And the local CFO, which is the chief financial officer, of course, that is a judge, a chief judge in a bank. And you look at all of these things taking place over and over and over again. I have witnessed this, I don't know how many times. Because it says in 1 Corinthians 13 that I'm supposed to witness this until you guys get it. As I said a few weeks ago, I'm tired of witnessing these things. Because there's so much consent involved. And I realize that so many are indoctrinated. But this is just, come on, you gotta wake up here because it's coming down the pike. They're killing you faster and faster and faster now. The other day, CDC came up with some new reports. Already they had listed 42 females per day are dying of prescription overdose. Now they're saying 46 humans are dying every day of overdose, prescription overdose. So there's four more there every day. At the end of a year, you got a small city that's being wiped out by these attorneys. These are you and your neighbors and the medications that you are partaking of. These things that you're buying into, the concept of diagnosis in the first place. And then all of the related product that the attorney sells you from the law merchant. Everything is codified, and you are such a great product when you're consenting to these things. These places, I don't want to hear a case of the attorney suing himself and then charging each other for bribery. 46 human beings in the United States Incorporated are dying every single day, being murdered by these attorneys for profit. I don't care how they ran their business of murdering for profit. Bribery is nothing in comparison to 46 human beings being slaughtered every single day. Now, what's funny is that these attorneys are coming in to sue themselves and each other as GlaxoSmithKline. And then I see stories of doctors being charged for giving out prescriptions when nobody's touching the FDA. Nobody's touching the FDA. Nobody's touching the Ethics Commission. Nobody's touching the UN that's promoting medical propaganda across the world. Now, the UN is most specifically peacekeeping. Peace is a bad, bad word. It means pact, agreement, pacts. It's the kiss of death. The UN is kissing people as it moves across the globe with the kiss of death called peace. This thing is the hand of Congress, and it's killing human beings and promoting religious, political, medical, legal, and governmental propaganda. Of course, this is through the Broadcasting Board of Governors, who's controlled again by Congress, and whose board member happens to be the clearinghouse, John Forbes Kerry, discharging congressional bankruptcy by using human beings. And what he's doing is equivalent to throwing human beings and feeding them to lions. But it looks really pretty here in this society. Everything's all prettied up with bows on it. When in reality, he's facilitating the same action. It's just a different lion with a different mouth open. I thought it was very profound today to see Google accepting orders from anyone, and this is tongue-in-cheek, of course, because Google itself is maintaining under corporate governance and cashing in on these things. And, of course, they're all led by these attorneys that are only out for the bottom dollar, but they're getting things shuffled off the internet now. Oh, we don't want anybody to know what we did or said before, and I want my privacy. So the courts are coming in and saying, okay, you can delete that off the internet. For what purpose? Now everybody's living in this cloud now. Everybody's living in this artificial womb called a matrix, which is what that word stems from, womb. And they're not in a relative state. They're not out observing each other, committing crimes or anything else. They're all sequestered in their little house bubbles or their work bubbles or their car bubbles the majority of the time. And under what relative state could it be possible to then have a relative delete button and say, no, I didn't do that. I want it gone from the existence or from the mind. And these are the things that attorneys are constantly creating behind the scenes. They're working on not only, you know, civil engineering, but also on the construction of what appears to be society at the same time. You know, these various platforms are absolutely profound in their creation. And of course, you know, as we talk behind the scenes, it's ingenious what was thought of so long ago. You know, Galen was quite a profound group of individuals. You know, it was much like the Vanna Circle and the others, you know. But it doesn't fly anymore. You know, somebody popped your balloon there and stuck a needle in it or something. But humanity, you've got to stop living in these fictional zones and places. You know, you take the national commercial space programs, and that to me is something that's even more not just awe-striking but horrifying at the same time, because it's so loaded. I mean, it adds so much weight to humanity when they're put into another box or another place that's only created in the mind. National space, of course, is a geographical state, one written about geograph. And you've got the commercial space, which is just written about and called, you know, corporate interests or corporate structure, which of course, well, when you look at it, it's that house built on sand. It doesn't have anything holding it up because it is fictional. You know, that's one of the requirements of you know, under any law or any source of interaction with what was actually the court process or court. Jesus said you're supposed to decide to rule on your own matters. You know, 1 Corinthians 6, we see that very clearly as he tells you to, you know, don't go in front of their courts, don't do these things, don't put your body in that situation. And on top of that, he says, you've raised up the Lord God, so shall you raise up us up by your own power. Then you look at the Constitution, and sure enough, you vested your power in Congress. So you raised up Congress, and you've allowed it to create these national and commercial spaces. It never existed. The federal state is still a non-existent state of being. It's not a relative state of anything. And, you know, on top of that, you've got it grasping you and seceding your estates by taking up names and titles. And this isn't just the last name. This isn't just anything. It's the any kind of title. You know, we were reading earlier about Lindsay Lohan. She took up the title of psychopath. She says, that's me you're talking about. I'm suing you for copyright infringement because you're talking about me. And that divorcing female did the same thing without any name being dropped. She says, "Oh, you just called out a psychopath on your wall, and you're talking about me, so I want a restraining order against you." And nobody saw that as what it was. It was absolutely crazy. That's absolutely insane. That was the same action as, years ago, who's that actor? David Letterman. He had a woman bring forth a restraining order against him. She said she was watching the television, and through the television, he was harassing and intimidating her. And it's the same insanity if somebody comes up and says, "Well, you were talking about me," when you're describing a psychopath. These things are, you've got to get your priorities straight. You've got to get your mind out of where it is. It's not even thinking anymore. And realize just what is happening here. These attorneys are cashing in every time they you turn around. From Black's Law Dictionary, first edition, NAM, NAAM. The attaching or taking of movable goods and chattels called vis or mort, according as the chattels were living or dead. And of course, it refers to terms de la ley. Terms, conditions. NAM, NAM, in Old English law, distress or seizure of chattels. As a Latin conjunction for, because, often used by the old writers in introducing the quotation of a Latin maxim. Excuse me. Nemer, Latin, of course, in old records, to take, seize, or distrain. Nemacho, Latin, in Old English and Scotch law, distraining of or taking of a distress, and impounding. And impounding. And of course, the Federal Reservation comes that impounding. You're taking up names and titles because you want reservation of your rights. You want rights superior to another. And that other wants rights superior to you. And back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Matthew 27, by envy, you're crucifying each other. Leaving each other on that cross. By envy. Not just that you're taking up names, you're also giving names. You're taking up concepts that say, well, that guy over there, he's poor, so I shouldn't be around him, and that they're a different class than I am, they're a different color, they're a different religion. And the attorney's pitting you efficiently. It's getting you. Satan has been able to get you to turn on each other. And you are holding each other on the cross. Casting lots. Instead of taking Barabbas, getting rid of that murderer, you've still got each other strung up. Something wrong with that picture. Something very, very wrong with that picture. Just never ends, if you're not holding attorneys accountable or Barabbas accountable, you're just letting each other hang there, and it is so sad to see. More harassment suits. Bloomberg. Obama says for the reforms needed to rein in Wall Street. America's economy is disabled. Well, I hope so. Attorneys are backing the Federal Reserve note now. That debt note. They love to litigate. They love to act. They like to do things. Very efficient product. You don't have to prompt them. You know, that's something that was really profound for me to see with the construct. The downfall of the construct, of course, is the massive amount of financial and labor market that has gone into the indoctrination system. Because an attorney or the psychopath, it doesn't have to be taught to do anything against itself. It already does. It doesn't like itself. So it's very, very efficient product, and there's no overhead. Absolutely no overhead when you have the attorney as the surety. It guarantees an outcome itself. It hates. It has so many flaws in its model. Without the frontal lobe, it doesn't have impulse control, first of all, so it's a sure bet for consumption. Without that frontal lobe, it doesn't have any impulse control stopping it from harming itself and, you know, its brothers and sisters. But I don't want it around humanity. It has to go produce elsewhere, which of course which was written in the genocide order back in November and again in December, October and November. And you know, it doesn't need prompting at all. It doesn't need education. It doesn't need anything to make it perform. It's an actor. It acts as to whatever is most conducive to market conditions. And in that state, it's absolutely beneficial for any corporate structure to maintain the attorney as the surety and the guarantee. Volkswagen denies planning a bid for U.S. PACCAR car. That's Reuters, it looks like. Ecuador says China signed $2 billion oil deal to access crude. That's at Bloomberg's. Ecuador's state oil company got $2 billion in financing from China backed by future crude supplies, adding to the funding the country has obtained this year by tapping the bond market. Hopefully they bought the right security there, because otherwise we're going to have to deal with that too. Strong jobs report leaves some unanswered questions. The New Yorker. Tragedy of the Arabs. Economist.com. More ways to interact with economists. These things, these presentations by the CIA pitting you against yourselves and each other. You know, that's we were talking about that last night on the Bone Rocker show. It's you know, the presentation is put on by Congress and its cronies. And one of the most profound was when Dianne Feinstein came out and was saying, oh, we're also spied on by the NSA. And I just busted up laughing. Dianne Feinstein is on the Senate Intelligence Committee. She's the one that's directing the CIA and directing the NSA. So if there's ever an opportunity for her to be spied on, it would be at her own hand. She's the one that directs it. We'll be back after the break, folks. Stick around. Hi, and welcome back to the second hour of Leaving the Farm right here on Revolution Radio, freedomslips.com. Also, at right here at TammyPepperman.org on No Borders Radio, of course. We are listener supported. If you'd like to donate to Revolution Radio, please visit us at www.freedomslips.com and click on our support pages. And of course, for TammyPepperman.org, it would go through our web hosting services. And of course, that is tamworthwebdevelopment.co.uk. Ben does that out of his own pocket, and I can't explain how much that means personally to me, especially with what I did to myself and the site when my administrator quit a while back. It was left in my hands, and then within like 3 weeks I had broken it, and Ben jumped in there to volunteer, pick it up off the ground, and that was something I will never ever forget. If you would like to donate to Ben, he donates not only the platform and the web hosting, but so much, much more. Please do so at ben@tpuc.org through PayPal, or just visit tamworthdevelopment.co.uk. You can also find that at tammypepperman.org, and we'll get you where you need to go. And again, we thank you for supporting us, not only keeping us on the air, but also keeping us on the web. It's interesting to see children's doctor at the hospital charges sex abuse on the BBC. Earlier, this is Cambridgeshire, it looks like. Let's see here, let me get to it. Children's doctor who worked at Cambridge Hospital has been charged with 8 sexual offenses against boys aged between 11 and 15. Miles Bradbury, 41, of Haringswell, Suffolk, who worked as a pediatric hematologist at Addenbrookes Hospital, is alleged to have carried out the offenses between 2011 and 2013. It is not known whether the alleged abuse took place at the hospital. Dr. Bradbury will appear before magistrates in Cambridge on Friday. He is charged with 4 counts of sexual assault and 4 counts of engaging in or inciting a boy to engage in sexual activity. In addition, he faces 2 charges of making indecent images of a child and 1 count of voyeurism. A spokesman for Cambridge University Hospital's NHS Trust, which runs Addenbrookes Hospital, said the doctor no longer worked there, but would not comment further. Of course, you're going to find attorneys on that trust, the Board of Trust. They cash in on both sides. They charge him for the use of the children, and they cash in through the medical industry and insurance on the back end from the diagnosis of those children who are now diagnosed as sexually abused. These attorneys are very efficient at what they do. All of these tests and SATs and all of these scores, it tells the attorney what product goes where in a corporate schematic. You've already got your pedigree, where you came from, and Plato said the same thing way back when, both in Cratylus and, I'm not thinking well, he said, basically tell me your name and I'll tell you where you come from. You come from a background of this, and this. You're going to go here, and here. There's nothing that is unpredictable in a socially engineered society. Fortune generation warfare is very efficient under low-intensity conflict situations because they know where you're going to go. They know where you're going to end up because you're accepting those titles. Now, when you drop those titles and you stop taking up and casting lots, you're no longer predictable in any, quote, nature. You read the Treatise on Human Nature by Hume, and you can find out right away that quote, nature of human is not as to its biology, because the biological physical aspect of humanity would not be taking up concepts and things that are formed in the mind. They would only have perception and take and grasp whatever was experienced. They wouldn't be taking, grasping science or any of these other consensus reality aspects of this created womb. That was another beautiful thing to see on Pravda.ru today. Americans live in the matrix. Oh, it's dated a while back. It was making the rounds again, it looks like. The remarks below are excerpted from President Putin's meeting with Russian ambassadors on July 1st, 2014. Putin damns Washington's puppet president of Ukraine, an usurped position resulting from the overthrow of a democratically elected president, for taking the, quote, path of violence which cannot lead to peace. And of course, he has a very perverted view of what peace is. He must be reading Webster's. And in this, his peace doesn't coincide with the same peace that the Confederacy is offering Russia and the Ukraine. Because the United States Incorporated is offering a pact, an agreement, treaty ability. They want you to be part of their corporation, and the Russian Confederacy has been. It was in the bag with Reagan. It was in the bag before that. It was in the bag way back in 1917 and 1922 again, when the UN perpetrated the onslaught against the Kazakhstan Muslims, killed 50% of their populace, and then offered them westernized medicine to cure whatever they whatever disease they employed upon them, just like they're doing right now in Africa with the Ebola virus. It's the same thing. It's the same perpetrators, the same medical propaganda. So they've come up with some twists, because when they found out that they could get human beings to consume chemotherapeutic antibiotics, which tear the body apart, it blows their immunity up, it lyses everything, and the body starts to break down and it begins decomposition. And in this, they sell the concept of AIDS and HIV, which is immunodeficiency, but it's not caused by sexual relationships. It's not caused by anything other than these antibiotics. And the same thing goes for other detrimental things that you are consuming, sold to you by law merchant. Lavaquin. Years ago, the United States Incorporated came in and said, oh, we're going to take quinine off the shelves because you could find it quite easily. And so you were consuming it until then. They were testing it on you. Then they found out that, yeah, it'll kill some of these bacteriums. So they started using that for, such as the gimmick of the swine flu, H1N1. Hydrogen one part, nitrogen one part, which your body produces when it's exposed to anthrax in a certain concentration. At a higher concentration, your body produces H1N5. Hydrogen one part, nitrogen five parts. And in this, they can sell you quinine again as an, quote, antibacterial or antibiotic. Quinine is the same thing that causes tendon tears. So they're not only dosing you with anthrax, and you can read all about how they've been playing with you as human test subjects in the 1999 anthrax hearings themselves. As I said, they were dosing you before the 1970s, and that was their fallout here. You know, because with the advent of the swine flu and all of these derivatives of bird flu and all of these things that are stemming from anthrax exposure, they've been practicing on you so long in a rush to depopulate that human beings have built up an immunity to variants on anthrax exposure. So they're not getting the results they wanted for the what they've applied. And I know this is sick. I know it's disgusting. And it's up to you to stop consenting to these things. Stop consuming these things, diagnoses and other titles. Because we've evidenced that they'll sell you anything. They have the ability and the smooth tongues and the media to sell you anything. You know, I look at these products and the disposal of fluoride in the toothpaste and the disposal of fluoride in the water supplies. They got you to consume poison. And then they upped ante, and they've been known and evidenced to be disposing of radioactive waste beneath your feet using the concept of fracking. And what happens when you have a natural disaster like an earthquake caused by fracking or the diesel coil? The attorney cashes in. It owns the medical industry and the legal industry as you sue each other. It owns the insurance industry as you make these claims. And it never ends until you hold it accountable. That thing is, it's not only a predator, it's a plague, it's a blight upon humankind. It has no purpose, it serves no purpose for humanity. It doesn't protect humanity, it doesn't make anything, it doesn't create anything that's good. Its goal is eugenics. How easy to manipulate and use the human being and then dispose of it in an efficient manner. These things are chilling to the bone to see and witness that they can be so accepted for so long. It's interesting to see on linkis.com, ex-Teamsters president charged with embezzlement, Louisville, Kentucky. The former head of the Teamsters Local 783 in Louisville has been charged with embezzling funds from the labor union, making illegal loans, and criminal record-keeping violations. A federal grand jury in Louisville charged 53-year-old Jerry Thomas Vincent Jr. on Tuesday. The indictment alleged that from October 5, 2009 through about August 17, 2011, Vincent embezzled approximately $17,272.84 in union funds from the union, arranged $23,760 in illegal loans from the union local to himself from November 2009 through July 2011, and committed 13 criminal violations related to union records from October 5th 2009 through June 17, 2011. Now, of course, if you go up to the Human Rights Commission, it was, of course, created by attorneys in Congress, you'll find the International Brotherhood of Teamsters Union is the Human Rights Commission. That union is the Human Rights Commission, commissioned by Congress. And is it, as the unions and the attorneys of the same entity, they take your rights on one side and then they sell them back to you on the other. But they're the same entity. They're the same thing. That's, you know, what is it? The State of the Union address, Obama. He says, look, female federal employees are still getting paid less than males. And all of the citizens, they heard that. They're like, oh my gosh, everybody's sexist. No, wait a second. Wait a second. Obama came in on his platform and claimed to be a feminist. And through the action of Hearts and Minds, which is a war tactic, he sold females the concept that he was going to fight for your rights and he was going to get you equal pay. So you voted for him. And just now, a couple months ago here, in his State of the Union address, Obama says, you're still getting paid. $0.75 on the dollar to what males get paid. If you are on federal employment. He was not referring to the private sector. He was not referring to the citizenry. He was not referring to males. He was referring to Congress. Congress is paying you less than it pays males. Because that's an easy way to pit you against your counterpart. And if you're pit against your counterpart, divide and conquer, you're easy to be preyed on. You become easy prey. And again, you go back to Congress. It's a thing preying on you, along with its attorneys. There is never a need for feminism outside of banking. They require feminism to teach you that you are not, so that you can earn the right to be. And what do they sell you? More education, maybe some loans on small businesses, maybe some rights here and there. But if you go back to my conversations with Otis Davidson, and there was one more around December, Michael. If you go to those conversations and listen carefully, because these are two divorces from all the way across the country from each other. And the male loses its butt, and the other male lost its butt. And Michael, he lost $800,000, almost $1 million. In the conversation, I said, okay, well, your female was pit against you and she worked for the attorney, so how much did she get away with? Nothing. She lost the house. She lost all the toys because of the attorney fees. And she ended up with nothing. Words on a piece of paper, maybe, principle. But she sold her soul for nothing. It just looked really pretty. And it had a big bow on it because she had a really well-spoken attorney. Pitting Adam and Eve and getting at the garden there. And the attorney always gets away with the garden if you let it and you don't hold it accountable. That's its function. So Putin's mad at America, and of course, there's a quote in here. On Monday, June 30th, I spoke with France, Germany, and Ukraine via telephone. I stressed the need to prolong the ceasefire and the creation of a reliable mechanism for monitoring compliance with the ceasefire, and that the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, or OSCE, should play an active role. I offered the checkpoints on the Russian side of the Ukrainian border could be monitored by representatives of Ukraine and by OSCE to ensure joint control of the border. Since 1917, at the earliest, and of course, the latter trade agreements and treaties with Russia, the United States Incorporated has been trading human product for a very long time. But it's interesting to see Putin kind of waking up, and it looks like he's bought into a new concept, this OSCE. So we'll watch this to see how it works out. Of course, the CIA on the ground promoting civil war doesn't help. You know, I urge everybody to go look at Dick Cheney's interest in war. And his involvement, of course, to not only Blackwater and Halliburton and everything else, but also as, you know, an efficient businessman who likes to traffic in children and males and females. And these are the same folks as Obama and Biden. Joseph Biden is one of the worst. The Violence Against Women Act, of course, was a privacy law enabling predation of females and children. And it was the same thing with Leahy's Crimes Against Children Act, CICA. It's a privacy law protecting pedophiles within the White House, its administration, and of course, I can't even use the word corrupt politicians because it started out as a corrupt concept in the first place. It would be very rare for you to find politicians. Well, it's so rare that we have three accounts throughout what I know of history, and that was Charles Lindbergh, when he was going off on J.P. Morgan, the law firm, back in 1917, and calling it out as a criminal organization then, and then, of course, they shut him up when they took his son and killed his son. Then you had Thomas McFadden later, and then our sister Nancy Schaefer back in 2010. And it's very rare to see any politician, Senate member or House member, that is not dirty and foul to the bone anyway. Very rare. And even to, you know, this day, I question whether or not Nancy would have gotten out of politics. You know, we know that she got out then, but her platform was, you know, of course, slightly different than ours. Even then, she's kind of hammering home on the corruption of child protection services and the adoption industry and things like that. But she would have had way more knowledge than what she purported to have at that time. But I will never ever cast doubt because, of course, she was helping us. So, you know, going down the line of thought is probably not, it doesn't take me anywhere. It's just, it's been amazing. And I know that tonight's show is probably all over the place. I think it will be for the next couple weeks as we revamp or whatever we're calling this. I can't even begin to explain the last hearing. The Mary Kay Wagner et al. Was indeed found guilty of genocide and by the court, and it's just been profound to watch the dominoes fall, of course, and to see the other side's military coming forth to, you know, rear its head up in protection of these pedophiles and predators of humanity. And I didn't expect that level of patriotism. As I really thought that I was hoping, I didn't think, I was hoping that some of those agents were actually good guys. They just happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time. And then in the end we found out, no, they're horrifying. They're just as bad as Mary Kay Wagner and her cronies. And it's been an interesting journey. Whoever wants to volunteer to be arrested, just stick your head out there and let us know whose side you're on. It's no skin off my back if you're arrested. It actually helps my people, my citizens. Because without you, there is no general welfare. So, again, I guess I should thank all of the psychopaths for being psychopaths. Because that's what makes the world go round. And that was the original intent of the Constitution. Corporations were to be paying taxes for the general welfare. Article 1, Section 8, Clauses 1 and 2. And since the attorney didn't want to volunteer back then, we went ahead, and as the new surety, they're going to be, you know, well taken care of by the marshal. I can tell you that. And of course, there's other surprises in store, but I'm not going to speak my intent and let you know what those are. You know, this week we had an infant taken off of her mother here. We talked about we've got some advertisements that aren't going to go away. From healthydebates.com, police confiscate healthy baby because it was not born at home. These attorneys are saying, hey, we got dibs. Well, no. You see, I own the lien on all of humanity. I am the United States. And until you pay off that lien, you are volunteering to assume those charges under the rules of shipping. 46 U.S.C. And this will not be happening anymore here shortly. And again, it's no skin off my back. I was told what to do and where to go by my directives, and I did that. And in this, I suffered many, many things by which to hold you accountable. That's how you evidence works. It's what creates a revelation. Somebody has to volunteer to suffer and bear all things. 1 Corinthians 13. And in this, I didn't come in with allegations or suppositions. I came in with the evidence of you praying on me. I came in with the evidence of you preying on humanity. I came in with evidence of genocide, and with the evidence of human trafficking, and with the evidence of betting on them, and gambling, and promoting prostitution. And not once did I make an allegation from something pulled from the rectum. And that's something that's so profound to watch now as Congress stands before the parliament and asks for immunity. And it asks, can't we just hide this? Because, you know, we don't want another government coming in the future and coming up against us for what we do. Well, the thing about the Foreign Sovereign Immunities Act, 28 U.S.C. Chapter 97, that's actually not in place in very many places, very many countries. It was Congress who decided upon that law and upon that particular act to maintain a business structure and to allow it to sue each other as foreign states. And yet, under pretense and under the guise of a public service, the United States of America was claiming that it was a sovereign state. Well, it acts under acts of commerce and private acts. So all it does in commerce and navigation, which, of course, it disallows immunity and sovereignty in any manner. A sovereign state, of course, is one that adheres to the public law. There is no immunity. There is no sovereignty when you're out slaying human beings, when you're out perpetrating war against human beings under any soft-cell manner, such as fourth-generation warfare, or low-intensity conflict, or through the use of hearts and minds. Those are war tactics. And this last time I experienced so many things. And when we came into court, and I came into court as a prosecutor on Monday, of course, as a clerk, and I asked the judge for a finding of genocide, and indeed, that is what I got. And I also asked the judge for a finding that we were at war. And that's what I got. The judge came back and said, indeed, they did declare war in 1947 through the National Security Act. And indeed, if our law enforcement has necessity of an army, it can be put together through funds from the Treasury. And then, of course, the judge, because of the threat of the attorney, put down a $250,000 bounty on attorneys. That thing is preying on everything of life, not only humanity. It's got cops killing dogs. It's cutting down trees to support its habit of litigation. It's creating in the mind that murder can be called something else and it's not murder. And that things that are unlawful can be called legal and it makes them okay. Under the doctrine of necessity. Whatever is not lawful shall be made legal by necessity. That is not okay. That is war. That is war. And humanity cannot sustain under such onslaught. And without an option, on Monday I came in on hearing and I asked the judge for a finding of such and the ability of law enforcement to be funded for whatever is necessary to protect us from this onslaught. And the most beautiful thing happened. As we were preparing for this hearing and we were gathering our evidence and everything else, I was put into fear. I'm a human being just like anybody else. And there's so many things that are so scary at times. You know, like declaring war on the United States Incorporated and it not being a presentation like what Korea does when they fax each other and say we're at war now. You know, I don't act under the Broadcasting Board of Governors. But the most profound things have been happening and the contacts and the humanity that I found when I got to this point in time has been so overwhelming and so beautiful. And I keep forgetting to tell everybody, just thank you for being. You know, I don't realize that I realize that you're around me and that you've been surrounding me, but I don't realize that I need to, you know, say something. It's been a long journey, and in the last 15 years I've been running and running and running and running and running and going and going and going and going. And then, you know, we started laughing about this even just a month ago, and we said, you know, we kept going and running past the finish line. And it's been such a profound experience for me because I never thought that there would be a stopping point. I never saw a stopping point. You know, I prayed for a stopping point. That's my whole purpose and my function is to stop everything. But as I've said before, I didn't think that I'd see it in my lifetime. And I figured that we could just ease the burden from our children that would carry on with the torch, and then here we are at the end and the all of these things. And it's been just a very, very profound and overwhelming experience. You know, these are uncharted waters. The last thing we heard before Revelation was Jesus was on the cross. It's been interesting. Arthur's picking up speed. It looks like CNN's reporting Arthur gets meaner. Emergencies in 23 North Carolina counties as hurricane nears. They've got a lot of fear-mongering going on, folks. Remember that in 1864, through the Geneva Convention, the attorneys got together and said that the Red Cross is a place to store prisoners of war. So don't contract with that thing. Try to take care of each other as much as you can. Make sure each other's safe and secure, and protect each other. Don't allow each other to go into that place of holding for prisoners of war. Looks like CNN's reporting three indicted in train track death of assistant on Almond movie. Of course, from CNN.com. Three members of the, quote, Midnight Rider movie-making team have been indicted in the death of a camera assistant. Randall Miller, Jody Savin, and Jay Sanders were charged Thursday with involuntary manslaughter and criminal trespass regarding the death of Sarah Elizabeth Jones, a camera assistant on the film. Jones was on the set of the Greg Almond biopic when she was struck and killed by a freight train near Savannah, Georgia on February 20th. The indictment notes that Miller and Savin are the owners of Unclaimed Freight Productions Incorporated, the film's production company. Sedgwick was the executive producer. Under Georgia law, involuntary manslaughter carries a potential sentence of 10 years. Now, under public law, there's no such thing as involuntary manslaughter. If it's an accident, it's an accident, and nobody cashes in on rent of human body. That's exactly what's happening. They're going to redistribute Unclaimed Freight production through a criminal presentation. And the family's been taught that, yeah, that money can compensate for the death of a life. And the family, her family is going to be rung through the ringer. There's all sorts of experts they're going to throw in there. All sorts of probate tactics. IRS is going to come after them while they're on their knees. And these attorneys are going to cash in using the same tactics they've always been using, unless you stop patronizing this thing. Stop accepting these tactics. Stop accepting these concepts. Stop buying these things. Renting a human body is bad. It's horrifying. An accident is an accident. If I step out into the oncoming path of a train, that's a sad accident. Doesn't matter how I stepped in front of that train. If it was my step and I was not pushed, it was an accident. Now they're going to come in with OSHA and all of these things for employment services, and that's the same attorney cashing in hand over fist on the death of a human being. These things cannot be tolerated because this society is just absolutely in a depraved state when you're taking up all of these concepts and ideologies. Sick. I guess on a video on CNN says City Council free pot for homeless. That'll help. You idiots. It's just these hearts and minds tactical play. How is that going to warm their belly and keep them warm as you're raising them? How did they get homeless? Ask the local judge who foreclosed on their house or burned their house down for them. Or did whatever else in fourth generation warfare to make that human homeless, to create a third world country, or whatever else these attorneys are playing with, you know, at any given moment in time. And it's so foul that these things can be even contemplated as any form of reality, relativity. I get so angry. I just want it to end. I want one day all of humanity to wake up and just realize that they already are. They don't have to earn the right to be. They don't have to buy their rights from attorneys. They don't have to buy any benefits. They don't have to do anything except for be human. And no more of this garbage. These these concepts and the way of living is just profoundly perverse. It's absolutely perverse. It's in opposition to your relative being, in opposition to your well-being in its entirety. From the dailybeast.com, painkiller overdoses kill more than one American every hour. A new CDC report highlights America's growing prescription opiate drug addiction, due in part to overprescription, which causes 46 deaths each day. Are drug monitoring programs a solution? Absolutely not. Why are you going to pay the same attorney who is pushing the drugs, promoting the drugs, making the drugs, selling the drugs? How's it going to help if that same attorney is a drug monitoring program as well? You're just paying them more now, and not just your beings. You'd only be fanning its pocket. And what needs to happen is the drug needs to disappear. The fourth generation that required the drug in the first place needs to disappear. The fourth generation warfare. The low intensity conflict needs to disappear, and the depression goes away. That word depression means to press down upon, depress. So you get rid of the attorney. You get rid of the attorney and the fourth generation warfare goes away. Low intensity conflict goes away. Hearts and minds goes away. Asymmetric warfare is absolutely gone and doesn't exist when you level the playing field, because the foundation of politics itself, or that asymmetrical design, is non-existent when you stop patronizing the attorney, stop patronizing that thing, stop paying it, and stop buying from it. All of these concepts, designs, and ideologies that is being sold to you to the profit of the attorney and the detriment to all of humanity. Obama's ratings are low. CNN's reporting and Congress ratings are lower. Let's go there and look here. Yeah, and then there's other things. They're trying to pit other people against each other again. The immigration debates, the gay rights, straight rights, all of these things. This is Congress promoting civil war, which is not covered under any form of insurance. The promotion of war, acts of war, or promoting civil war is not covered under cover hold. Things of that nature. And so the insurers need to be aware. The investors need to be aware. Because it's going to be you who ends up at the losing end of the attorneys. And I'd really like to see Barabbas held accountable and those that are innocent let go, like it was supposed to be originally. A bunch of crap about fireworks. Political ticker blogs. CNN, no pulling fireworks for Obama or Congress's 4th of July. As President Barack Obama marks his 6th Independence Day in the White House, his approval ratings remain near the lowest of his presidency. 41% of Americans approve of the job the president's doing in office, according to a new CNN poll of polls. Wonder if all of those are the ones that were working on his wife's Twitter and Facebook accounts and stuff. CNN polls compiled and released Thursday also indicates that 54% of the public gives Obama a thumbs down on his job performance. It's just sad that anybody can patronize that thing, and Congress being Satan And I urge everybody to go over to Bono's Entertainment and check out the videos that are there regarding these things. I try to keep this blog updated and everything else, but Bo is much more efficient at keeping everybody abreast of the most recent and latest news. And again, I cannot thank you enough for keeping us on the air and on the web. And I do want to thank Ben for everything that he's done. And again, if you'd like to donate to our web hosting, please go to PayPal and donate to Ben, B-E-N, at the at symbol T as in Tammy, P as in Paul, UC.org. And I can't stress that enough how much Ben has meant to all of us in keeping us on the air, keeping us on the web, and allowing us, this platform. There's so many things that I'll talk about on Saturday tonight. This week has been really overwhelming for me, and I'm still trying to process everything that has occurred. And so I apologize for being all over the place. They're doing so much stuff on the border. I want to deal with that on Saturday and probably tomorrow night on the public law as well, right here on TammyPepperman.org. There's another report from the Daily Beast. Hundreds of immigrants are rushing the border just to get caught. They're hungry. The same government is in both, quote, countries, perpetrating four-generation warfare upon the global populace since 1941 Atlantic Charter. Congress is in every corner of the globe, and through its International Monetary Fund, it acts so horrifyingly bad. And of course, it controls the scarcity of all known currency. And for those of you who only have the mental image right now of a dollar bill, that is not the truth, because currency is any commodity, including human resources. And when you go into the documentation, the evidence of genocide, you find that the directors are actually the Federal Reserve. And it's the attorneys that are worshiping that thing as its master. And it always has been. And it says this right in Matthew 27. Through Federal Reservation, Judas, which means with law in Anglo-Saxon, was given that bag of silver. And it couldn't be put back into the treasury because it was blood money. And you read through the whole thing and you'll realize right away who your enemy is. Who's been perpetrating this for so long. And just what you need to do. And Jesus kept telling you, Matthew 23, he's telling you, look, the outside looks great. It looks beautiful. Very, very nice. Man inside of that cup is full of filth and inequity. And that's how it's always been. Always, always, always. Politics always runs on the same thing. Remember to check out our Facebook, Tammy Pepperman, TammyPepperman.org, Bono's Entertainment over on YouTube. And again, we'll be here tomorrow night with the public law right here on TammyPepperman.org, No Borders Radio. Reminder to check out the Daily Beast. I haven't gotten through the headlines yet today. They've been doing really good reporting what needs to be reported. And we give them a high five here. And we'll be talking about more things as it comes. And the beauty of things is, you know, I talked about the fear earlier, but then when I realized I wasn't dead yet, it all went away. And everybody needs to realize that it's not that hard. It's not that hard. We just got to stand up and continue to be one. Continue to be here for each other. Continue doing what we're doing for the reason why we're doing it. This is humanity. There's nothing else on this planet other than life. It was the attorney that taught everybody a different version of life and to respect it or see it again in a different way and have everything under the sun represented in some way to us. And in that cartoon version of reality, nothing worked out. Nothing was good for mankind. Nothing was good for any biology on this planet. And we'll see you tomorrow night, folks. Be well.